now, because I don't know what now is.
I thought you said this was supposed to be TV hell. I'm having a time of my life here.
You mean to say you enjoyed that?
Mother's milk. You don't think there's some sort of fan club I could belong to, the Triangle Fan Club, where I could meet like-minded people?
I doubt it.
Perhaps there should be a badge, you know, like a triangle, that I could wear, and you see somebody walking down the street, yes, and they've got a triangle badge, yes, and you'd see that, and you say, oh, I see that you like triangle, yes, as well, and they say, oh, yes, I'm a great big triangle.
Sorry I had to do that, but we do have to get on. Right, now this is where a number of our most crucial operations take place.
So what's wrong with her?
Well, my doctors have to surgically remove half the brain from some people so they can become game show contestants. And surgically remove the entire brain from other people so they can become game show hosts.
Or disc jockeys.
No, with disc jockeys there's no brain there in the first place, so we simply have to fill the void with this.
Welcome to Rock Bottom. Until I became too old and misshapen for it to be funny anymore, I used to introduce the occasional Top of the Pops, and it occurred to me then that the spirit of an age is often better captured by the really tacky than by the more profound. Who better represented the early 1970s, the Bay City Rollers, or Mike Oldfield? What we're doing here, Pop Pickers, is celebrating the tawdry, but with a certain grudging admiration. I can live with everything in this first saccharine sequence, except Little Jimmy Osmond.
Presumed lover from Liverpool, and I'll do anything you say. I'll be your clown or your puppet or your April Fool. If you be my sunshine daisy from L.A., I'll be your leprechaun and sit upon an old toadstool. I'll serenade you till I'm old and gray.
Cars were funny things, frightening. Rolling hoops and spinning chops, tender beds and lollipops, comic cuts, all different things.
Granddad, granddad, you're lovely.
Thank you.
who was a book cherry.
I tell you what, I wish I had the pink ribbon concession on these programmes. Hey, you want to see some really crap haircuts, some of them featuring real human hair imported under licence from countries formerly part of the British Empire? I think I've got just what you're looking for.
Born from afar on a gentle breeze, joining the murmur of summer seas, distant tones of an old world dance, played by the village band, perchance on the calm air came floating down. The curious tone of the cornet, clarinet and big trombone, fiddle, cello, big bass drum, bassoon, flute and euphonium, each one making the most of his chance, all together in the floral dance, dancing here, dancing there, jigging, jogging everywhere, up and down and around the town, hurrah for the Cornish floral dance.
So I started feeling better, and I thought I'll start a combo, you know, just like that American fella.
This weekend the saga, the M1 motorway, are the biggest bloomin' convoy outside the USA. Why not join our lineup? It's completely free. All you need is transport and the current MOT. Convoy.
Hello, this is Super Scouse calling. Anyone out there? Come on. That's come on. What's your load, plastic chicken?
Well, it would have been quick dry cement, but the rain got it. Do you know anybody wants to try a 3-ton brick?
Oh, dear.
Jasper Carrot there, that's got to be one of the greatest names in the world, that one, hasn't it? Pan's people, and their successors Legs and Co, were perceived by some folks of otherwise pretty sound judgment as being powerfully erotic. Me? Well, I was always delighted by their absurdly literal interpretations of song lyrics. You know the sort of thing. I'm looking over a four-leaf clover. And as a rather ungainly chap myself, reassured by the lumpy way in which they frugged. Couple of years, football songs have achieved a sort of curious respectability, apart of course from those featuring Chaz and Dave, with the release of at least two pretty scholarly compilation LPs. However, even the most dedicated fan would have to agree, I suggest, that the football song has not transferred well to the small screen. You want proof? We've got it. Watch out for the great John Walk back in the big time with Ipswich, and a holiday for two in Tottenham if you can name the scorer of the goal. Just kidding.
I died praying. his knees have gone all trembly. Come on, you Spurs, come on, you Spurs.
When we reach the Argentine, we're really going to show the world a brand of football that they could never know. We're representing Britain and we've got to do or die. For England can't do it cause they didn't qualify. We're on the march, we Ali's army. We're going to the Argentine. And we'll really shake them up when we win the World Cup. Cause Scotland are the greatest football team.
You'll not believe this, I'm sure, but I've never really been a snappy dresser myself, so I'm not entirely clued up on fashion. However, even I can spot when things are getting out of hand. I mean, watch out for Noel Edmonds. I think it speaks volumes for his integrity as a broadcaster.